Alrighty.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the stream. It's time for a little bit later version of 18 Games and Counting, where today we're going to be playing The Bunker.
We're going to be playing...
I had to check my phone, or my watch.
Does your watch tell you what we're playing?
No, it was actually saying something completely different. 18 Games is later than usual. Did I miss an announcement? No. Well, I mean...
Yes.
Yeah, I guess you kind of did. 18 Games and Counting was rescheduled to noon this afternoon so it's like now.
It was rescheduled to right now.
It was rescheduled to now. Maybe Tara with a 25-month resub says, I missed my 2-year anniversary. Sad Aww. Times. I'm sorry, maybe Tara, but thank you so much for your continued support of the channel. Anyways, we rescheduled it to noon today so that we could do a live stream of the Apple event this morning, which myself and Paul and Ian just wrapped up about a half an hour ago. It was fun. I enjoyed myself. But yeah, if you had missed that, I apologize. We changed it in the calendar. I tweeted about it several times. That's kind of as much as you can do, I guess. I don't know. If you guys want to tell me what the best way of letting you know things are, that'd be great. Because we still, 12 years later, I would argue nobody on the internet. Here's the thing. I have discovered that we are not the only content creator that has this problem. By the way, it's not just a loading, ready, run problem. This is a problem that every content creator I've ever met and talked to about it has this problem, where they're like, I don't know what else I could possibly do to get the word out about something. There are still going to be people who are like, why didn't you tell us? And it's just like, I did. I so did. Okay. Should we play this game? I think we should just play this game.
The
stream was fun. I enjoyed the aspect of the stream. The announcements were like, they were okay. There was nothing earth-shattering.
Yeah.
Let's just say that. The stream itself, I really enjoyed. I thought it was fun.
On the plus side, the earth wasn't shattered.
A personal call from James would be best. Okay. I mean, if you guys want to, tweet at me your phone number or something, I can start calling you.
You should not tell people to tweet your phone, their phone number to you.
Don't do that. All right. Let's play The Bunker. This guy looks sad.
Alrighty.
Apparently, let's get some music going. Oh, yeah, there it is. The main guy is from, he played one of the dwarves in Lord of the Rings.
Really?
Apparently. Let's check out some settings here. This looks good. Brightness.
Seems a little quiet. But
oh, yeah. Let's go back.
Seems
there.
Okay for brightness.
Audio volume, subtitles.
On, yeah. Controller sensitivity.
I'm not going to use a controller. All right. Let's new game this.
All right.
Nothing earth shattering. Scratching DJ tracks with a touch bar. That's true. I apologize. July 3rd,
1986.
Government and military personnel, 58. So this is like a real, like, this is what this is.
Like an FMV game.
This is a...
So, yeah. We are not just watching a movie here. Although, maybe we are.
I don't know. Screams. I heard no... Oh, there it is. I don't have much experience with these kind of games. They seem super cheesy to me, though, so I don't know. Let's see what happens.
It's...
Keep pushing.
Keep pushing. Stop pushing! Stop pushing! Too much pushing! I think the last FMV game I saw was, like, Red Alert. Which had Tim Curry being awesome in it, so.
It's a boy. Well done.
wait, do stuff. This is a thing. Wait, breathe.
I breathed. I did it.
If you hadn't done it, would you just have killed that baby?
Well, presumably the baby's us. So I would have killed myself.
Jesus.
Press F to give birth.
Yeah. This is hardcore.
That number is going to go down. Wait. Oh, it's going to go up. Right.
Because
we were just born. Again, like, I'm pretty sure that's us.
The bunker.
This reminds me of Assassin's Creed. I think it's the second or third Assassin's Creed game starts with you reliving the memories of your past self being born, which seems like pretty serious. It's like, whoa! Serious trauma. Yeah, if you hadn't pushed the button to breathe, whoa. Oh, so this is like post-apocalypse.
I don't know. Well, let's find out.
So, like, we're all stuck in the bunker because shit went down.
I'm pretty sure it's we're stuck in the bunker, not everybody else.
Yeah. Just us by ourselves?
I think so. I think that's the idea.
They all left and left.
This wouldn't be a very scary game if everybody was around chatting. Jeez. So is this
Fallout?
Oh my
god. This is... Look at how old that computer technology is. It's so scary.
Treasure Island. Domestic nuclear shelters.
Oh, here you go. There's two people.
You've got to say it again, John.
Is that your mom?
I guess so. Yes.
You can't leave me alone, Mom. Still be here. Always be here. And you've got to say it again.
As long as I stick to the routine, I'll be safe.
Yeah.
As long as I...
He is a dwarf.
Stay in our rooms, I'll be safe. As long as I don't go outside, I'll be safe.
That's it.
So you and your mom...
Good boy.
Luca! 19 months.
What am I missing?
Yeah. Subs are going to kind of ruin the, yeah, the immersion of this. It's probably okay, though.
Pick a book. I can't pick a book. Okay, are we picking Treasure Island, Technical Guidance, or the Holy Bible?
To read to your mom?
I don't know. Okay, I'm picking this one.
The ultimate unit. Common capacity of the reinforcement concrete element.
Interesting.
Subject to the blast.
So just this, like...
It's a point and click.
It's just cutting between different movie clips.
Mom, please.
I love you, John. Be here. I keep you safe, I promise.
Aww.
Okay. This is just sad.
Yeah. So far, kind of a downer.
Yeah. Woohoo, we got an achievement.
Yay! Last goodbye. There's literally no way to avoid getting that achievement.
Yeah. So back down to 58. I think we're a lot lower than 58.
Routine. Medical vitamins, radio. Oh, no, okay, you're going to do... Wait, what's the mother thing?
Don't ask questions.
So, vitamins?
Why are there just some loose pills?
Yeah, jeez.
Put them in the bottle. Oh, whoops. Oh, okay.
Oh, do we have to pick the right stuff?
I can only pick two. I can pick this one or this one. Let's go with these.
Why do we have unlabeled bottles of pills?
Don't ask questions.
Like, this is...
Now we take this one.
This is his 11,000th day of doing this. But we haven't done this.
Yeah.
If Focus.
Radiation is just over 70 MR. That's acceptable.
Okay. Hey, where's our... There's our check.
All right.
Radio! Let's try it out. Damn it, wrong pills.
Checking to see if there's
a signal. If there's a signal. Let's go the other way.
For 11,000th day in a row, only crappy pop music on the radio. If only there were signs of intelligent life out there. Huh. Well.
Radiation check.
Wait, isn't that what we just did with the dosimeter?
I think this is probably outdoor radiation check. Or something, yeah. Computer screen. There it is.
Initializing.
Yeah. Yeah. Perform bunker radiation check. Running. Oxygen. Okay. Temperature. Okay. Boiler. Okay. Server. Okay. Water. Okay. Communications. Okay. Air filtration. Okay.
Bunker radiation is normal.
Hooray!
Good.
Good. Check. That text looks added in post. Yes, it sure was. I don't really want to... I don't want to get to the mother part scared.
I need to choose dinner.
Oh, sweet. I can't read the labels on things.
I want floor food.
Floor food?
Yeah. Oh, what? It's on a box.
Beans. Again.
Sorry.
That makes 27 years, 3 months,
Jesus.
And 14 days of food left.
Why are you... This is not appropriate. Why are you eating beans while shitting?
At least...
How bad are these beans?
Is it worse that he's eating beans while pooping? Or if he was just sitting with his pants off while eating beans?
All right, let's go check on Mother.
Not good.
Yeah.
I think is the...
Oh, no.
Oh, jeez. Oh. We go.
That's like skull.
Yeah, that's not good.
That's super fucking creepy.
Welp.
Oh. Oh, no, I have to... Okay, I'm not clicking here. I'm clicking the Bible.
She liked it when I read to her.
Okay. I will read to her some Bibles.
Cast thy bread upon...
Oh, jeez.
Mother conditions. Suboptimal.
Thou shalt find it again. Give a portion to 7 and also to 8. And thou knowest... What evil
yeah,
be
that room
there.
Has got to be a little
if
whiffy.
If the cloud be full, they will pour out rain upon the earth. If the tree fall to the south or the north, in that place...
Lord, my advice was visit death.
Okay, can we check off the mother aspect, please? Okay, thank God.
I mean, to be fair, if we did the mother thing and we went there and she wasn't there,
yeah.
That would be a concern.
I kind of feel like at some point we're going to do that, right? Like, it's a creepy, scary game. Okie dokie. I'm curious.
This game doesn't seem so tough.
Yeah. I understand they're going to make us do... Oh, okay.
You don't have to actually...
You don't have to click the things anymore. I do have to click this one, though.
Radiation is nearly 80 MR.
Jesus.
It's increasing.
Was this the next day, by the way? Was this 11,109 last time?
Anybody know whether 80 millirads is actually a scary amount of radiation?
This is how you remind me of what I read.
Nope, nothing. Nothing there. Everyone's dead.
Yep. Perform the check.
I remember for a while when I was in university, That song was playing like all the time.
Okay, we did radio and radiation check. Now let's do some food, which
let's
I guess.
Go for nut beans.
I don't. Do we get a choice? Nope.
27 years, 3 months, and 13 God, days.
Why? Now. Stop it! I don't want to. Anything other than this? Oh God.
Maybe.
This is really unsettling.
Yeah.
We had a dreary morning's work before us. There were no sign of any wind, and the boats had gone out and manned.
Oh, he's reading Sheila.
He's reading Treasure Island down, yeah.
Is that the only book in here? Up around the
narrow passages. I can't imagine it's the only book. I assume it's like their favorite book. My guess would be one of the boats. Poop and beans. Poop and beans. All right. Bookworm. On to day 11,111.
Ooh. Whenever all the numbers are the same, it's time for a party. It's the saddest party ever. That's going to be a problem. It's going to be like...
Sakult with that Twitch Prime sub and Kaus Jason with that 18 months in a row. Double sub, baby. Thanks, guys, so much for your continued support. And your new support. And click. And holy shit, it's above 80.
Oh, jeez.
Radiation is... 80 mR.
What? When it's, for who? What is it actually checking?
That's like ambient radiation, I think.
Like in the room?
Yeah, well, because it's in like a thing. So it's got to be measuring, like it's must be measuring the radiation from something.
I feel like...
One of these times something's going to be not okay.
System error.
Oh, geez. System error.
Wow. How many
server failure.
How many notepads did they bring? Yes, Psychology Boy, we are getting a loyalty badge. We will be doing that. I think Graham is actually going to try to work on that this week. Wow, we're just getting achievements like nobody's business.
The procedural manual. Where is it?
Creepy wooden figures.
Oh, great.
That's your mom.
That would be creepy, except for the fact that... okay, maybe open one of the doors. Turn off the monitor. It'll go away.
That's what I would do.
Click out.
Wow.
Maybe open the drawers?
Yeah.
Where's the manual?
I don't know.
Top drawer.
Ocean News subbed. Diary. Looking to see everyone in a few weeks. Awesome.
Extra peaches, oh god.
My favorite. And there was a candle. Mom gave me this book and some pens. Look, here are the colors. Vera sang me a ring a ring of roses. She said she was crying because she is happy. It's my birthday. And then she and PJ and Louie and Mom sang me happy birthday.
It feels like there's some info here that we're gonna need.
Blew up the candle. This book is going to be my book about my friends. Today I will start a new friend. He will look like this. He will be a soldier because I have a general, but I need a bigger army. I've got a blot from the map room, but I had to hide. Mr. Bishop was there. He nearly saw me. He was shouting. He says I am a waste. I think he's a waste. I will make the soldier, and Mr. Churchill and Joan of Arc will tell him to fight Mr. Bishop. We had ham today. It is sort of pink and sticky. It is better than sardines, which are the worst. Mum has made my knife sharper so I can finish off doing my soldier. She says Rocky was the best at winning fights, so that's his name. I finished Rocky, so here are all my friends.
Oh, Commissioner Zexed out.
Yeah. Okay.
Today it is my birthday, okay. And I have had extra peaches.
Put it back.
So he doesn't keep his diary anymore, obviously. Only when he was really young.
And next drawer.
My underwear drawer.
What?
Why is that in
is that your underwear drawer? That's your desk drawer.
Shouldn't the manual be somewhere? Oh, there you go. Okay, good.
The manual.
In the event of server failure, make announcement that mains power is being shut down for maintenance. Find fuse box located in storage room level 2 and identify damaged fuse. Locate replacement fuses. Shut off main power. Wait 10 seconds. Replace damaged fuses. Switch main power back on. Perform a system check.
Wow.
Okay.
Back in the day when the fuse box level fixing a computer involved changing fuses. Level 2. We don't go to level 2. Not since the accident. Toy collection,
Mum.
Okay.
Isn't there a big pile of them right beside
Yeah, this is, they're all literally right there.
Don't need to change.
Okay. Apparently at some point we're gonna need to change.
You can dress up.
A security camera. Okay, so we can't go this way. So
really? You think your mom would have been like, look, you're gonna be by yourself, so you may have to do some of the routine maintenance stuff.
Yeah, exactly. Why do I feel like he hasn't been out of his room in 20 years? Or ever? Come on, buddy. Let's get your shit together. It's locked, of course.
I need to find the key.
Okay. What about this?
So he and his mom can't have been by themselves for that long. Like, they can't have been by themselves for 30 years or whatever.
Oh,
because
no.
He would have to know
no.
How to do all this stuff.
No.
No. Please just no-scope the key. Wait, what? There's nothing in here I can touch?
I can't use anything in there.
Okay, fine.
Probably like in your mom's pocket or something.
Oh no! Why would you say that? Hey, key!
Yes.
The key.
Yeah, the diary mentioned other people.
Now I have to leave.
So it's unclear as to how long it, like, when the last person who wasn't your mom died.
Yeah. Yeah, we're just getting the fuck out of here.
Yeah, it's a bad sign when the room where the corpse of your dead mom is lying is considered one of the safe rooms.
Yeah.
But the idea that he's never opened that door.
Couldn't pick a username with those bits, really appreciate it. And Twinklebees with that 8-month resub. I can't think of anything interesting to say. That's okay. Thank you so much for the support. Oh, it's one of those places where level 2 is down. Flashback.
Doop, doop.
That's a really good casting job, by the way, for the young version.
Yeah, it's true.
14 months, at best. If we carry on as we are, 8 months. But I've gone over it with Dr. Hart. On bare minimum, we might make 14.
And bare minimum means?
I didn't like to press him, but scurvy, rickets.
This is famous food.
Then we all just withered away to skin and bone. Maybe I should have just left the hatch open and gone for a nice stroll in the fresh air instead.
What do we do?
We tell people everything's all right.
It's not all right.
One whiff of this and you'll have your throat slit over the last tin of peaches. Is that the way you want to die, Sam? Fighting over scraps? We could just cut your wrist now and the rest of us will split your rations.
Good news is the rations are going to last a lot longer now.
Mm-hmm.
It's 10 minutes until the next bulletin.
That guy's got a good voice.
Fighting over scraps. Split your rations. Is that the way you want to die, Sam?
Oh, that stairwell cam, though.
Angor 33, so you're saying 80 millirads is not actually that scary. But it's a bad sign, I guess.
This is level 2, so we don't need to go down more.
This is still in the flashback.
No, that wasn't a flashback.
Is that?
No, that was him walking down the stairs.
Oh, I thought that was still the young kid.
No. No. Good God. Please have lights.
Yeah.
So we can go through.
It seems like he would know more about this place.
We can go here, or way over
tape
here.
Tape recorder. There's always great things on tape recorders.
Yeah.
Dan, this is Alex. Please send this out to all the Berkshire stations and let me know. Thanks. Hello. This is Alexandra Swan. I'm trying to contact my brother Jonathan Swan. When the 4-minute warning came, I was on the phone to him, and he said he'd got a place in one of the Berkshire bunkers, but I don't know which one. If he's with you, and his wife's name is Sarah. John, if you're there, or if anyone has any news on him, please let me know.
The subtitles don't match up, which is a little weird.
Yeah. As somebody in the chat points out, apparently 80 millirads or whatever is not necessarily that bad, but the fact that it's going up and that we are theoretically in a place that's protected.
Oh God. Last contact, October 1792, unknown, oxygens, goodbyes.
Rad breach.
Air system failure.
Word. Okay, well, it doesn't seem like a situation where it's like a misunderstanding, acute gastrointestinal failure.
Possible radiation sickness.
Yeah. So this doesn't look like one of those situations where we're like in a bunker, but it's actually totally fine outside.
It's going to be fine. Okay, so maybe fine isn't the right word, but we have enough supplies to make it through, I'm sure of it. If we can just keep it together and be sensible with the rations, then we can make it. Sure, none of us are going to get fat down here, but I could use losing a few pounds anyways. 9th of December, 1996. Oh, this is Sam. So this is the guy that the army dude was talking to, right? I assume.
Right.
So this is his computer, I guess? Things I miss. Eggs and chips. Having a bath. My bed. Warm sun on my neck. Grass. Chocolate. Natalie. Things I hate. Sardines, the bunker spell, and level 5. Okay. Well, I look forward to going to level 5.
Maybe we won't. No, we're definitely going to
level 5.
Communication from Bunker HQ, Site 3, Corsham, Wiltshire. Prime Minister delivered safely before blast hits. 4,013 government ministers and civil servants, including cabinet office, local and national government agencies, intelligence and security advisors logged in. Shortage noted in domestic support staff. Guess they didn't make it. All facilities operating normally. Checks carried out in infirmary, bakery, laundry, kitchens, telephone exchange, storerooms, office space, living accommodation, maintenance areas and workshops. How big is that place? Trust me, you get sent to this sardine tin.
Yeah, I feel like there's not a bakery in our place.
No.
Accommodation. Twat. Other. Civilian casualties noted outside bunker. Group of 50 attempted to breach rear exit blast door. Aggressive action not required. Activity ceased after blast.
Well, yeah, because they died.
Bastards.
And then he's playing Hangman on this top secret note. Mm. And the word is prison. Okay. Which means the only place left to go is over here.
This reminds me of like in like the Avengers.
Radiation warning map. So level 5 is a cooling system in sewage.
So level... one of these would be lit up.
So wait, level 1, our room, mom's room, I guess.
Storeroom and
sickbay. Where the hell does everybody else? Okay, whatever. Level 2 is the main office. And then we're standing right here right now. So electrical, office 1 and office 2 are offices as we can go into. And then there's level 3, which is a war level.
Level 5, why no one likes level 5 is that's where the exit is.
Oh, that's where you go up the stairs to get out. Okay. Sure. Okay, so electrical, office 1, so electrical, office 1, office 2.
So we need to go electrical, right?
I would assume so.
Although we have to find the replacement fuses first.
Right. Well, we'll go to the electrical first.
Only open one drawer at a time.
Nothing in here that
these
I can
are not well filed.
I wonder what filming this thing would be like. Jesus. Old vinyls. Alright, well, let's go inside.
Yeah, the FMV game with modern tech is interesting. You don't have that thing where, like, it used to always be that, like, you had the stills and then the video would be like.
You really don't need to make the announcement. Seriously?
But the, you used to have that thing where the video would be like 256 colors or something. Like, the video would be.
Yeah.
Different resolution, and so it'll be obvious when it switched.
We've been up all night. It's been 10 minutes since I had to cover Vera's face.
But is it radiation?
I don't know yet. The nearest proper lab is under 10 tons of radioactive rubble, and I have to make do with a microscope.
It's all right, George. We'll run some tests, Mr. Bishop.
Is anyone else showing signs?
Yes, 6 others.
Quarantine. Right away. Find out where they were working.
What were you supposed to do?
What they've had contact with and what they've been eating. We need a source.
So the problem with everyone being in the bunker is if somebody gets sick or whatever.
It's all right. Come here now.
Oh, it's your mom.
Oh, my guess is I would not have been found.
It's all right. You know, if you stay in your room, you'll be safe.
So, I'm guessing we probably would have heard more of that conversation if I
don't like it here. Commissioner.
Oh. Sick. No one likes this one. That was the one that was crossed out on the his book.
I don't think he likes it.
There's nothing I need here.
Hey, NBC suit.
I wonder what happened to the NBC suit. What's the NBC suit?
God, security cameras.
This Five Nights at Freddy's mod is not cool.
Okay. Let's just go ahead and turn all those off. Actually, I'm curious. Should I turn those on and then go back out? I can't. Interesting.
Can't waste power. So nuclear, can't. Biological, and chemical suit.
So I can't. Alright. Alright.
Weird game to be 18th on the Twitch list. Yeah. Blame.
Attention. The main's power is about to be switched off for maintenance purposes.
I feel like that wasn't necessary.
Thank you!
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Oh my god. Made by F.W. Hurley. Worrying brown residue around bulkhead seals B number 7.1, B number 7.4 through 9, and B 7.12. Don't know what to do about this one. Rubber compound shouldn't be perishing yet. Indicates corrosion from something in its contact with. Unless the cowboys use cottage cheese instead of VX compound, which, given how the rest of this place is built, wouldn't be unlikely. Respond by C. Bishop. ? Nothing we can do. No replacement seals.
Fair enough. Ignore it. Hopefully it'll go away.
Number 2 rear bulkhead beam next to the recycling unit in A number 15 showed stress fracturing through paint surface. Two rivets loose, welded, but looks like similar progressing in roof beams 2 and 3 along adjacent wall. PJ says not major structural issue. But if it flexes anymore, it might spring a seal loose and we could be in rad trouble. That sounds awesome. You're in rad trouble. Best we can do is foam sealant, but we're running low, or seal off A15 completely. Responded by C. Bishop. Gone through drawings with PJ and Frank. Can't waste foam. Told Frank to install additional Geiger in A15 so we have enough warning of rad breach. Number 3. Unexpected moisture in C12. PJ says might be condensation from the filter system, but one of the purified lines runs right behind that wall. Worried that we might have a leak in the water system.
Uh-oh.
Oh god. Request permission to set down the system and take off the wall panels between C12 and C13 to look into it. Hopefully it can be fixed in it that way. Trouble is, if there's a leak higher up, we can't get to examine it because the ceiling there is a solid weld. Filter spec sheet says condensation can be caused by rapid warming and cooling of filter system. No cause for concern. Okay, so C. Bishop is just like, don't even worry about it. Everything's fine. God save the queen.
But it's just this thing, you know, that brutal thing of like.
Okay, looks like.
So now we can go back and turn off the. But it's just, it's like you're in the closed system, right?
We still need fuses.
So there are no replacement parts for anything.
Let's see what's in here.
Yeah, that's a good call. Let's get fuses before we turn off everything, all the lights.
Yeah. The doctor. Damn it. Who's this? These are not in order, which is just frustrating. Ooh, dose. Okay. Effects on human. Virtually no short-term effects. Some nausea. Nausea and vomiting within 24 hours. Some incapacitation after 2 days. Some mortality. In N9V?
Everything is fine. Stop asking questions.
N and V. I don't know what that means. In under 4 hours, symptoms freeze. N and V in under.
Oh, Black Wolf says there's a box of fuses, was there a box of fuses on top of the panel?
Oh, there might have been. Yeah,
it's the, yeah, I mean that's that. There is that real, that thing of like there's no resupply, there's no nothing. So it's like what you got is what you got.
Yeah. Oh, nausea and vomiting. Yes, you are correct. Nausea and vomiting. N and V, N and V, N and V, N and V over 600. N and V immediately, die in a week. Neat. What's this one say?
AB welcomes. CB asks clarification purpose of meeting. AB puts forward petition from 18 residents keen to institute post of morale officer.
Okay, the fact that this is tilted is pissing
that
me off.
It is felt that CB is not forthcoming enough in communicating current status of bunker to residents. CB makes point that any urgent change in status will be communicated very clearly to all residents when it becomes relevant.
Calls for a vote.
No need for new position.
CB says vote will be ignored. This is not a democracy. Meeting ended. Fair enough.
All but FH, DM, SC are unaware of said incidents.
Zero tilts. I guess there's one tilt now.
N. Turner. That's my dad.
calls on F8 to clarify incidents.
By which that is F8 his initials.
F8 not of immediate concern. AB raises point that lack of trust in bunker hierarchy
I feel like
is
the,
causing morale issues. More clarity.
I'm, you know, well, I'm sure your dad has many great qualities. I feel like window coverings were probably not a big concern.
Probably not.
In the bunker.
Comes to light, all will be made aware. Requests enter meeting as urgent business to attend to. AB calls for vote on appointment of morale officer.
We did make a game like this.
Yeah, you see the Loading Ready Run CD-ROM game?
Yeah.
Meeting ended.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, you could definitely make a game like this these days. Hell,
so
you could make
it's certainly a lot easier than it used to be.
Hell, you could make a game like this using web technology now.
Let's say, for example, the hit on Reading was 1 megaton. That would mean we have this radius. Only halfway to Basingstoke.
This is the big problem,
now,
right?
Small,
just that there's no info.
But that's around 100,000 fatalities. Maybe 80,000 injuries from the blast and the fireball.
Things
that's
like Twine. I thought Twine was only,
Prevailing wind direction here is northeast.
I thought Twine was text only.
It's likely to drift all the way out past Cambridge, past Norwich even, out to sea. The total number of casualties? Unimaginable. And that's one bomb.
I'm okay. Sucks to be...
Anybody seen...
Oh, right. There's this thing. What?
6 weeks. How can anyone expect
oh my god.
There must be a leak. There must be. Mr. Bishop says
I know what he says. He doesn't want everyone to panic. Silly old Vera having another one of her turns.
Uh-oh.
Look. Oh, that's great.
Look here. More blood. I'm not being silly.
Yeah.
I'm not.
Once the coughing up blood happens, that's when the silliness stops,
yeah.
I think.
Okay. Stop.
Anybody seen 10
go.
Cloverfield Lane?
I still haven't watched it yet, no. I need to.
It's good. It's good.
Yeah, no, I know.
But highly relevant to this game.
I had issues with that, the movie in general. But
with the Cloverfield?
I had issues with the marketing that they did with 10 Cloverfield Lane.
I
was not pleased with the way they marketed that movie. I understand it's a good movie.
Because of the Cloverfield stuff? Or?
Yeah, I think that was misleading.
Yeah.
And I think that's kind of uncool.
Yeah, it's the Cloverfield thing seems weird.
Yeah.
I will say, not to have any spoilers, but if there's any relationship to Cloverfield, it's extremely peripheral.
This one.
That's the damaged one.
Wait, what?
See, I had to pull it out first.
That's the damaged one.
Okay. So, what?
I should turn the power off first.
Oh, okay. Back then. This thing. Oh, God. Oh. We're gonna turn all the lights off, and I don't... Scary things.
It's not that scary.
Damaged views.
I mean, that was definitely not that scary.
But it's like, there's all the scary noises, but it's like, if the lights had just turned off, super scary.
Yeah, the noises.
If the lights hadn't turned off when you turned the thing off, that would have been scary.
Yeah.
Now, if the lights don't turn back on, we have a problem. Okay, good.
What happens when we run out of fuses?
which we just did.
Yeah, it's like literally we have one fuse that's supposed to last us the rest of eternity, or at least the next 23 years. Ooh, what's this?
Sam.
He is nice and smiles to me.
I like when the what you want to do is like you turn off the lights, replace the fuse, and you turn when you turn the lights back on. There's like a big monster is like. Awkward. Excuse me. Back.
I get the feeling that this isn't a monster thing.
Well, there's a picture of like a guy with a...
I have a bad feeling about this.
What? Why do you have a bad feeling about this? Literally nothing has happened. Ooh. Oh, what? Okay, do we want to go down?
Why would we want to go down?
Yeah, I agree.
Time to reboot the computer. I mean, the thing is like a picture of a guy with an axe on it. Which I'm hoping is just like an axe hand thing. Game over.
Game over. You fucked up.
You should have gone down. Oh, missed bits.
Please be okay. Please be okay.
What?
Oh, Richards, thank you for the 100 bits. Appreciate it.
Yay!
Birthday bits for James. Thank you so much. I will take that $1. Okay. Let's go back to the computer.
Yes. Please insert CD2.
Quick check on level 5 and then back to mom.
Huh.
We did it! Oh! Oh, god damn it.
No. NBC suit required. Well, the locker is empty.
I need to find an NBC suit.
So Zane in that locker.
I don't have an NBC suit.
And the one downstairs is gone.
Down to level 3.
I guess.
I need an NBC suit before I can go to level 4.
Yeah, there must be one on level 3.
In no universe am I going back into my mom's room. Ever.
Maybe your mom has an NBC
suit. She's actually wearing a suit? That would be actually kind of amazing. And also really creepy, actually.
Paul, why the bushy beard?
Because he hasn't shaved for 3 days. okay, I want to... One step flashback. It's gonna happen. Call it now.
I need to go down.
Yeah. It's crazy. Like, he actually hasn't left that floor for whatever. At least, you know, significant number of years.
Oh, I was expecting a flashback. Well, I think if your mother drills it into your head for literal decades that you need to stay in your room, that's where you're safe. I'd be terrified to go anywhere.
But that's weird. Like, you think, I mean, obviously when he's a kid, yeah, but like, you think when he gets to, by the time he gets to like 15 or something, he would start like helping with the maintenance around the place.
Well, I mean, you saw him at level 2, right?
Like, yeah.
There was that part where he was at level 2. I just don't think he, yeah, I don't know. We don't know at what point people died, though, right, too? Like, we don't know how long he's been alone for. Or at least we don't know how long he and his mom have been alone for.
The war room.
Do we know how long his mom's been? Okay, so they have the war room, and they've got the map. So they must have been getting some info from outside.
Yep.
So, yeah, it's... How long was it just him and his mom? And how long has it been since his mom died? Like, his mom seems to be, like, a skeleton. So it's been a while. A little bit of time, anyway.
Well, I mean, he hasn't aged significantly,
but he hasn't aged
though,
significantly,
right?
Significantly,
so,
yeah.
Oh, shoot, sorry.
Well, Joan of Arc, you can be right at the front with the tanks.
And he looks to be about, what, 10 here?
Yeah.
So out with it. What couldn't you tell me yesterday? There's no hope for any of them.
I don't know.
Well,
love you.
It's not radiation poisoning. The water's clean, the air is clean, it's not the food. And yet the symptoms. I can't shake the feeling that someone is up to something.
Damn it, George. We don't have time for your fantasies. You need to figure this out with facts.
We don't know where this thing comes from or how it will spread. We have no cause, we have no cure. We just don't have the resources to deal with it.
There is no help. There is no cavalry.
So there's some sort of sickness.
It's just us.
But it wasn't radiation.
Together and fix this, do you understand me?
What's that?
Cooling system.
I'm sorry, Mr. Bishop.
You weren't figured out then.
Yeah.
This place, it's full of ghosts.
Don't worry about the ghosts. Whew. Okay. This is definitely not a...
Okay. Anybody live in any of these places? Sucks to be you. Alright, back we go. I guess.
This is definitely not one of those, like...
Soldier.
My prayers matter.
It turns out that it wasn't actually that bad thing, and it's being inside the bunker is the scary part.
This door will open automatically in the event of an emergency. All right, well, let's go in here first.
Door just opens.
Oh, no. Light. Whoa. The fuck?
Is that like the last... Somebody went crazy.
In the event of a nuclear radiation leak, the following items are required for complete protection: protective clothing, respiratory equipment, and rad detector. Provided highest available level of respiratory skin and eye protection from solid, liquid, nuclear, or gaseous chemicals. Ensure suit integrity has not been comprised by wear and tear, rips, or punctured before use. All right. Oh, okay. Neat. Appreciate that. What's in the bag?
That's
a rat.
Yeah. Geiger counter.
Okay. And can't turn off the light, and nothing else to explore. And
it's locked.
That door is going to open at some point. It's terrifying.
So Oop. Where? So now we have to go down to level 4, right?
Yeah.
What we don't know for certain is the contamination levels. We can calculate the likely fallout and its effects, but we don't have any good model for anthrax spore spread, or even how it's affected by radiation.
What?
Look, we do know from reports at AE3 in Oxford that anthrax was used in Wave 3. We've just got no idea of the extent of it. It's not as if we can go up and test anything. We can't even count the bodies.
So they got nuked and then chemical warfare.
Yeah, Jesus Christ. Sucks to be you guys, UK.
That is
and
thorough.
And I guess parts of Europe as well. God.
So
Some shit happened.
Somebody went crazy wearing a radiation suit. Presumably, because they're like, I have to get out. We're all going to die in here. Yep.
I feel like Alex would dig this game, actually. I wonder if he's...
I'm surprised he hasn't played it.
I'll talk to him about it when he gets in. Maybe there's a reason.
I mean, it has a gas mask in it, so it's already like halfway there.
It's already on brand.
Holy crap, this seems all bad.
Yeah, should we be at all worried that there's like no other bodies, BT dubs? I guess maybe they've been cleaned up. I don't know. I'm really freaked out about this.
Oh.
Okay, we can go over here. Let's go into here first. And turn on the light.
Maybe.
Light still works. It's good.
Maybe this room is just like the Schwitz.
Air filtration unit check. Day 18th of October 95. 1611. Check by BJT.
I didn't used to sound like this.
Running okay. Cleaned out and replaced filters. Check back up just to be sure. Readings are a bit high, but Frank says no need to replace at the moment. Probably just as well. I'm concerned about our stock level of filters for the main unit. We're chewing through them a lot faster than spec says, due to higher outdoor rad than expected. Frank says he'll have a word with Bishop about stocks and sorting out the backup longer term. PJ.
Okay. Computer? Critical! Fault detected! Main air filtration system status active. Filter effectiveness 71%. Oh, that's fine!
Yeah, that seems
that's
fine.
A passing grade.
Disconnect pressure main valve before continuing. Backup filtration offline.
Okie dokie. And it's in these drawers. Oh, goody, an accident book.
So
accident report.
I appreciate that everything is
August 92,
voiced.
1910.
It's kind of cool.
Filed by F. Hurley.
The,
Ran scheduled test of backup filtration unit. Rad levels way
first too thing they ran out of was ink for all the stamps that they put on everything.
I thought it was a Duff filter. Tried a new one. Same.
Sacrificed a Geiger. Stuck it on a rod and ran it round inside the casing.
We've got contaminated dust clogging the lower hex duct. God knows how it got in. Might be a hairline, or maybe the filter just couldn't cope with the levels being so much higher than we expected. This is really, really bad. Without taking this apart, cleaning, resealing, and decontaminating the whole thing, it's useless. We have no backup air filtration system. But I can't see how we can do it. We don't have a clean space to do this in. Bishop just shrugs pretty much. Keep it quiet, Frank. You'll only worry people. For fuck's sake. What else isn't he telling us?
Yeah, that's the first swear word that I think we've seen.
It's a useful acronym there. FFS.
Yeah, man.
It's good to know.
Oh, yes. Give me another toy. Oh, wait. This isn't... What the shit?
The engineer.
Oh, okay. Woohoo! We're doing super well. Okay.
Apparently somebody, either you've been down here or somebody's been like
stealing
your
toys. Stealing our shit, yeah. Okay, so this is the only drawer I can interact with? Yeah, okay. Wait, what? Seriously? I have to, that's weird.
You have to open it before you can leave?
Yeah. Their cuts are really good, by the way. Like cut from static to it's like super smooth. Okay, let's go over here.
Wow,
it seems very bad and loud. There's the main pressure valve. That is not ladder safe. Oh.
Alright.
Okay. Whew.
Problem solved. Now we just have no air.
Yeah, I was just going to say, I think we just turned it off, right? So this is bad. Shaking hands with danger is right. Okay, so now we can go over here.
Oh, jeez.
And what?
I do not like the gas mask breathing noise.
It's pretty bad. Okay.
That seems like a great thing to have a big crack in it.
Yeah, I can't interact with that in any meaningful way. Oh, there's something.
We need to replace the filter, right?
Oh, there we go.
It's gonna be like a body in there. Like that's what's disrupting the. Oh, that's bad.
What did you expect?
That's. Ah.
That seems not good.
That is a lot of stuff. There's one right there. Yeah. You can see a few things.
We have two. Awesome.
We need to get rid of this damaged filter first.
Put it on the ground.
Oh, here.
Oh, I see, because it's radioactive. So you gotta.
What?
Alright.
That does not seem secure at all.
I thought those would have been a little bit more.
Just open it up. Dealt with. Also, I would assume that in a situation like this, the filters would be maybe a little bit more heavy duty than this. Two of these filters are keeping this entire complex good. Maybe that's your first fucking problem. Jesus.
This was made in 6 weeks, so yeah. That hole in the little filter thing doesn't seem like what would cause all that smoke from, like, or the steam or whatever going everywhere.
Turn the pressure valve back on.
Yeah, I figured that. Come on, man. I'm a this bad. Okay, nothing else. Ladder.
Yeah, shouldn't we check the second filter?
Oh, we're gonna fall. Euripides, 23 months. Hey, Dr. James and Paul, just played Minecraft in VR. Dr. James, I feel it. You might enjoy it. Yep, we're gonna fall. Ladder safety, kids. Okay, well, this is kind of silly.
What did you turn on or off? Game over.
Hey! Achievement! Achievement unlocked! Air filtration. Wait, I'm so confused.
He's coming!
Who's coming? Oh, the creepy guy with the axe? What is going?
Something happened to his hand?
Well, I mean, it looked like he, like, fell and broke his arm, so.
But did he turn the thingy back on?
Well, he turned it back on, but then the ladder also fell.
And hit a thing.
And it hit a thing, and the rad started going up.
Did he not notice that, though? It's weird that we noticed it, but he didn't.
Well, he wouldn't notice it.
The question is, are things... I guess there's the possibility that things could actually be okay outside now.
Or that they were always okay outside.
Well, it didn't seem like that, because they had all the reports of people dying and stuff.
Yeah, reports can be fudged.
That's true.
Social experiment, man. Stick them in here, tell them they can't go out.
Oh, that would be the worst. This is just a reality TV show.
Okay. If that is the twist at the end of this thing, I'm 100% in. I just want to find this dude and give him a hug.
You don't want to do that. He's radioactive.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's going to be like bone or something nasty. Don't drool on it.
I assume I'm supposed to be doing something. No, don't look at it. Oh, wait. I feel like that's not bone. That's actually just something that's like a piece of the ladder, maybe? Hacksaw minigame. I can't tell if that's like supposed to be a broken bone or something that has gone through. No, it's not something that's gone through him because he.
Interesting idea. Lucy Awesome says the fact that you keep watching yourself through security cameras sort of implies. Yeah, it's definitely bone.
Is it though? I can't.
Or it kind of looks like wood.
It kind of looks like wood, but then it means it would have pierced like radiation should be it. Oh, I'm supposed to. No. God.
Then again, I've never actually seen bones sticking out of my body, so I don't know.
Ow. If it's a piece of a ladder, then why is he pushing it back into himself?
She can't have had her white cell count so low yesterday, and then so hard to understand it. And she's no better.
Vomiting, bleeding, diarrhea, liver failure, it's got to be.
It can't be radiation sickness. Look, these...
Of course it can. This place probably leaks like a sieve. It was built by the lowest bidder. No one thought there'd be a real war. I know Bishop said that we'll be safe here, but honestly, George, do you believe him? I'm sorry.
No, don't worry. We've all been under a lot of pressure.
This is the worst hiding job of all time, by the way.
You and Evelyn had it from Mrs. Harrison.
Two unopened bottles there on Monday. We have to keep on top of the stock. We can't have...
What is it?
Nothing. It doesn't matter.
Box of artichoke. Is that what you need right now? Making a splint.
Yeah. Wait, what?
Like,
you should clean that off first, buddy.
Clean that off or something?
You're terrible at this. Or I guess we're terrible at this. Okay.
Yeah, I feel like this guy lacks a lot of important life skills.
Well, he's been stuck in a bunker his whole life.
Yeah, but you think how to treat a wound, like the things they could have been taught.
Well, first off, maybe find better tools to, you know, fashion a splint out of. He has already drooled on it. What else do you want? That's fair. All fixed. Don't worry, dude. Everything's gonna be fine. Just go eat some beans and have a poop.
You always feel better. Oh. It left that thing turned on, right?
Yeah. Wait, the ladder was still up.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Hey, we noticed that that was messed up. It's not our fault that he didn't notice it.
I'm actually kind of an... Oh, God. He noticed something running towards him, by the way, there.
Did he?
It looked like it.
Broken.
Good achievement. Radiation. We should take a break. This might be a good time to take a break.
Can we pause?
I assumed. Yeah, you have to be able to. We'll get through this little part to the next choice. I'm assuming you can pause this game.
Probably should be wearing his outfit.
Holy shit.
Keep your damn
mouth.
Dead.
I was just exploring.
Oh, John.
I want that door sealed shut immediately.
For Christ's sake, Margaret. Keep your little shit in his quarters before he explores the wrong place and gets us all killed.
Seal that door immediately.
Zombies. All right. Let's take a quick break. We'll be back in a couple minutes, and we'll keep going with this kind of tense game.
All right.
Hang tight.
Dum dum dum. We're back.
We're back.
Wait, wrong side. Ha!
Now we're back and in the right corner.
Yeah.
Resume game! I guess. If I must.
Yeah, could we not?
So, do we go to the darkness?
If we don't resume the game, things won't go badly. As long as we don't play this game, it won't.
I'm kind of curious how long this film goes.
The little loop?
Okay, there's pinching.
There's that. There's the, that's that thing from FMV games. There's always the thing of the guy, like.
Wow, that's not that long, and it's, I don't see a cut at all.
Yeah.
It's like a 10-second loop. Anyways, do we go through the door or to the darkness? Through the loop, or the door, right? This seems like a terrible way to go.
Yeah. I mean, it's gonna be terrible regardless. But yeah, we made fun of that on the CD-ROM experience thing. That thing where it's like, you're in the loop, and then once you push a button, it's like, and then you switch, jump to whatever it is. Oh, it cuts and then reverses. Yeah, that's probably how it does it.
Okay. Glasses? Nope, just some glass.
Not really, I know, I promise.
You think in the 20 years he could have swept up a little.
Okay. I don't really quite understand what just happened there.
So there's a hole in that window, eh?
Yeah.
So it's no longer a seal.
And we've finally been able to take some proper readings from the RA-14 sensors. They show we have a range of 700 to 1,000 rads for anyone exposed to the atmosphere.
What does that mean?
Well, anything over 200 rads can be fatal.
No. How long before it's safe to go back up?
Never.
Our best guess, 20 to 30 years.
Oh, hey.
That's convenient.
Great.
Sam, can we last that long? Do we have enough food?
Yes, you...
Hey, we're good.
Yes, it'll be all right.
Terrible
we
liar.
We have to ration a little, but it'll be all right.
You know, we may have to eat one or two people.
Yeah. Years, dude.
Yeah.
Let's just leave.
Don't even worry about it.
Yeah. Can I just go? Can we just go upstairs and go outside?
As a side note, if for some reason we all have to go into a bunker, I don't want Adam to be in charge of rationing. Well, there's a little,
Oh, dear God.
This is less good.
The escape hatch must be in here somewhere.
Love you guys. Keep up the good work.
Thanks, Kitty Kibitzer.
There's a
months.
Little wooden guy there.
Yeah. He likes smoking cigars, but saved us in a war. Not this war, though. Nope.
A hatch.
So is that where we're in? At this point, we're actually, like, trying to leave the bunker. Everything has just
gone
to poop.
Well, we have to, because the...
Everything has gone to shit?
Yeah, because we fucked up. Oh, God, don't use that arm. Oh, my God, that would hurt so bad.
Yeah, turn around and push it
Jesus
with the other
Christ,
shoulder.
Push it with your other goddamn shoulder, you dumb fuck.
Yeah, I don't want Adam to be in charge of rationing if we go into it. He'll just be like, yeah, don't even worry about it. Like, I am worried about it. I want to worry about this.
But if the outside was livable, then the inside wouldn't be full of radiation either.
Mm.
I disagree. I don't know why I disagree, but I disagree.
Yeah, maybe the maybe it's like the bunker has started to work in reverse. And it's just like storing all the radiation.
Oh, I guarantee you they did that shot about 1,000 times. That the hatch isn't where it was either.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It was at more of an angle, and now it's properly like that. And then it's like
yeah,
that
you're
again.
Right, you're right.
Oh, fuck that. Why in God? Oh, okay.
Oh. Because ladders have served you so well up to now.
I mean, at least at this point, I guess we don't never have to go back to Mom's room, which I'm okay with, because there's a creepy skeleton in there. Adam is totally medical officer? Oh my God, are you kidding me?
Ooh. Push a button, push a button, push a button, push a button! Oh.
Did it! See, you gotta add some stress to this game by taking your hands off the mouse. How did he mess up his arm? He fell off a ladder.
Not this one, though. A different
one. No, somebody's like, at least this ladder's a fix so he can't fall.
So, I mean, you know, don't want to get into this too much, with Talking Simulator and stuff, but I would definitely put this more in the interactive experience column than the game column, I think.
Yeah, I mean, I'm one of the people who just falls in the camp that an interactive experience is a game. Like, I feel like you're just...
But, like, if you hadn't pushed the thing there,
well, I'm calling.
I'm guessing you wouldn't have gone game over. It would have just... something different would have happened.
True.
Carol and I have been scanning all the bands for 3 days now, just in case. But there's nothing. The last contact we had with anybody was...
Ah, that's true. This guy has literally never been outside.
Yeah.
He was born in the bunker.
He was born in the bunker, yeah.
But, like, we don't even know if these are actually, like,
so that's it.
QuickTime events in that in the context.
There's no one else out there.
It's true.
Because if you fail them, there may not actually be any problem.
If I fail, I just break my leg.
The day this became our tomb.
Lovely.
Christ, I need a drink.
Just because they've... Alex and Cam have talked to me, it doesn't mean you're not allowed to talk about games. What I'm saying is I don't want to get into a big debate or a big thing about it on right now, but it is a interesting point that, especially, you know, with a game like this where it is sort of in the interactive movie area.
We're one left.
Oh, man. All right, like... go back up the ladder.
Go we got to go back.
We
got
to go back and get down.
Well, we don't know. The last one could be at the very end.
That's true. Like, I wonder if, like, for that there, like, would that just have waited with you struggling it forever or
probably,
what?
Probably, yeah.
Descent. Yeah. These achievements feel a little hollow.
I feel like we're going to beat this game pretty quick here. Like, from what I understood, it's not a very long game.
That's fine.
No, yeah, I'm... okay with it.
I'm gonna play some Minecraft.
Yeah, I got.
You can build our own bunker in Minecraft.
I got leather to mine or to farm for.
I was gonna say you're mining leather. Something has gone very wrong. It's when cows are buried underground. We've got a there's a thing for that. I have a puppy glaring at me from my bed. Is it your puppy?
Come on, quickly, we can get to this way.
Ah, there's the thing. So, obviously, you know, there are limitations because of the actors and stuff. But it appears that all these flashbacks are from around the same time. And we're talking...
Wait, what? What happened next? You just hit in the hatch. He had an axe.
Yeah.
How big is the download for this? I think it was 5 gigs. It wasn't huge.
Ooh, a torch.
A torch. Gimme. All right, back.
All right, and British.
Boop.
Is that the outside door?
I doubt it. There's still kind of some questions that haven't been answered yet, so.
Also, that door's not gonna open.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, 5 gigabytes. Which is interesting, because unlike most games, being that we have a fair amount of experience with video stuff, you can actually kind of work out.
Yeah. Wait, oh, okay.
I bet you could actually work out how much total video is available reasonably accurately, I bet. What? I mean, obviously you're not going to see it all in every playthrough.
What
but.
Is he doing?
Nice. Which one was that?
I think that was his mom.
Is his mom?
I think.
Oh, mom, come to the rescue one last time. Does it have arms?
God.
Jeez.
What's down there?
I'm trying to remember the layout of that from that map. Gregor for 18 months.
Double sub, baby. Oh my god.
I mean, at this point, going from one creepy underground room to another creepy underground room doesn't seem that bad, really. It's
that's more of a lateral shift.
Yeah,
that's
else.
True.
Haha. lateral.
Okay, that's a great shot.
No.
Holy shit, he left his mom behind. Oh, fuck me.
This
cannot be healthy.
Oh, is that like expando foam there?
Looks like it. I think so.
This. Ow, 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 ow. Yeah. I'll take things that suck to do with a broken arm for
any amounts.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just trying to remember that map, because there was a thing that had like secret, that had like emergency trapdoor.
Yeah. I don't think it was necessarily that heavy. I think it was that his arm is broken.
I mean, it's got to be relatively heavy.
You notice that he's not doing any voiceovers anymore. Earlier in the game when we found the locked door, he's like, it's locked. Now you're just not getting that, which I think is kind of cool.
Yeah, so all these are around the same time, so it's... It seems likely that ever since then...
Wait, is he just pulling out his keys?
Yeah, thought so.
Looking for the key. Why would I give you a way out, Margaret? You and the little rat are not going to leave.
Why not?
You're not going anywhere. We're all gonna die down here.
John, no!
Dominated.
So he's killed everyone else, probably.
Well,
or everyone else has died in whatever way, and it's just the three of you, and he's gonna. I mean, we know your mom.
This is gonna be an axe to the back, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, we know your mom didn't die, right?
Yeah, we know. Yeah.
He's gonna be.
Wait, what? That really easily could have gone through.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is gonna be one of those, like, Prince of Persia things where, like, he kills her and he's like, wait, no, that's not how it went.
Okay.
I did it.
My watch just told me to breathe.
I killed him.
It's probably about right.
Your watch is like, you've been holding your breath for literally five minutes.
Yeah. Please, for the love of God, breathe. Okay, so we have a general idea of what... We still don't know exactly why people got sick and died.
No.
But we know that...
A bunch of people got sick and died, and then presumably the base commander went insane. Also, your mom... And you were apparently unaffected, which is interesting. Also...
Is his body still going to be there, by the way?
No, the other bodies are around. Also, this all happened, like, 20 years ago.
You can see the blood streak.
That's unfortunate.
Oh, is this the last toy? That was weird.
I don't have much time.
So the fire exit stairs, you've already gone down.
We're going out. So let's go here. What's the passcode?
Come on, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah. One, two, three, four, one time.
The old bloodstained numbers.
Now, does that bloodstain match up with the dried up one? Because that's impressive if it does.
It's all right, John. It's over.
Try 69.
Your mom knew the code.
As long as I'm here, I'll look after you.
Well, she was one of the people in charge, it seems like, so.
Yes, Mom.
I love you, John.
So at this point, it's just the two of them.
Like, presumably?
Which is like 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Judging by his age. So they've been on their own for a very long time.
I wonder if he's been a DJ for 20 years. What? Okay, well.
Wait. Just like, look at this.
Sorry?
378.
37. Yeah, because most blood.
There'd be more blood.
Yeah, more blood, less.
Oh, wait, the 6 has got a little bit on it, too.
So
there's 4 numbers. So
3786.
86. Hack sword.
Awakenings. Okay, so there is going to be a dead body in here.
Hopefully.
Wait, what?
That's the point we're at right now. If there isn't a dead body,
that's true.
Things have gone very wrong.
Yeah, that's fair. Then we're in a very different game if there isn't a dead body in here.
I mean, presumably there are a bunch of other dead bodies.
In fairness, I don't actually... I mean, this might be where all the dead bodies are. Oh, God. Oh. Yeah, this is where... Oh, this is like the morgue.
Yep, this is where all the dead bodies are.
Okay.
It's also like, it looks like it's a freezer, too.
Why did we come in here?
This is the way out, isn't it?
Well, no, there's one other door that we could have gone through.
Oh, jeez, people are dying from air contamination. Ah, so this is what happened. It wasn't the slow thing, it was a... one thing that happened.
So some people got sick, and then there was a massive radiation leak by the looks of it. They're fine.
And then that's why he just... Ew. Yeah. He's like, they're fine.
Well, that was bad.
So he's assuming that your mom did something. And who knows, maybe she did. Your mom seems, considering the kind of rules that she gave you, as in you haven't moved out of those 4 rooms for 20 years, I feel like your mom might not be, like, the best.
That was cool. And creepy. Stand up! Stop crawling over! Oh, God. Stop crawling over the dead bodies.
Oh, the noise.
The noise is so gross.
There's some nasty Foley happening there.
Where are you even going? Oh, Jesus Christ.
So, yeah.
I assume you need a key from whoever this is? Oh.
That's decomposition.
Oh, that's so gross.
Okay. It is not a freezer.
These
people are totally decomposed, and now you've dipped your arm.
Hand in it.
Why did you do that?
That's your good hand, dude. Why would you do that? Nope.
Somebody's saying your mom killed everyone so that there'd be enough food for her and you.
Oh, damn.
That would be some stone cold shit right there.
So she need. I feel like we're. Oh. I was like, I feel like we're in a loop, but I didn't see any. Oh, stop with the noise! Stop it! Yes, Yes, more Folio is good. That's good. We need more. That'd be fucked up if we learned that your mom killed everybody so that you two would be safe. Ah.
Yeah, it's true. You probably shouldn't have... If you had stuck your other hand in it, then it would be like open wound. Ah, wait. That's fine. Right, he had the keys.
I feel like...
Your mom should have grabbed those.
Yeah, you would have taken those keys 20 years ago.
That was a little awkward switch there. Cold story. What? No, go out the back. Go out the door you came in. Don't go into the tunnel. What are you doing?
But there's scary people the other way.
Oh, yeah, so go into the vents. What the f-
Look, we never said this dude was smart. He's a dwarf.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we've actually said that he's being not smart. Go. Also, I'd like to point out that there was like a music sting when you saw that guy's the skull. But realistically, a skull was like literally the best thing. Like,
yeah,
it would be so much worse if he hadn't decomposed enough for there to be a skull yet. If it was just like a half decomposed face. That would be way worse than a skull.
Okay, now what, genius?
Yeah, what was the plan here?
Where are you gonna go? Ow.
Oh, now you've burned your good hand. Smooth.
When you reach level 5, find the ventilation hatch. Look for the hot pipe, but make sure it's the one with the warning label, John. Then open the top, be careful.
Jesus.
And you run back to me as fast as you can.
She did.
She did.
She fucking did it.
Is it, so who is it? Black Wolf, apparently?
You understand. You'll remember.
Wow.
Good boy. Be careful.
What a shitty person.
This is some dark, dark stuff
right
here.
Get fucked, lady. Jesus.
Wow.
You're a horrible person. And now this kid needs to live with the fact that So this entire time he has to live with the fact that he killed everybody. So that's fucking fun.
So his mom got him to kill everybody.
But how did she know that they would be okay?
Well, she presumably then went to a place that's sealed off, right?
I guess.
Wow. And it's like she did that so that they would, like, so that they could, you know, live together, but just kind of be stuck here forever. It's like, what kind of life is that? Jeez. Remember when you had two working arms? That was a good time.
Good days. You don't feel like the game reached the level of drama it wants to reach? I don't know about that.
It feels pretty dramatic to me.
It's done a pretty good job. I think it's limited by what it's trying to do, right? I mean, this could easily just be turned into a movie.
Yeah, I mean, there's that question: is like, how much did the interactive elements really enhance things? Aha! Now everything's gonna smell like pea soup.
Maybe close the door.
So what's his name in this creepy radiation suit actually was like the
so
hero. It was basically the hero in this story.
Well, yeah, I mean, so I'm curious, what did she actually, I still don't know what she did.
Well, I mean, she's one of the medical staff.
Yeah.
Right? You have agency, can you make choices? I mean, you can make choices as to what order you look at things, but you don't seem to be able to change anything.
I'm impressed that that small of a thing can boil and go through ventilation and kill everybody.
This doesn't have the aspect of that, like...
Oh, he's realizing what he did now. Because I don't think he had any idea when he was a kid, right?
Yeah. I mean, he's got to be seriously messed up. Like, is all his education... Because they wouldn't have had...
Yeah.
Because they weren't expecting there to be a kid there, right? So all his education is from either other people or, like, reading the manuals for different things, yeah. Right?
So when he said we're all going to die here, I'm guessing he meant you're going to die here with the rest of us. Yeah. That you killed.
Yeah. We're all going to die here.
Yeah.
What key is it?
Oh, I don't know. Well, you got three choices.
Wrong one.
Okay. Well, then let me choose the next one.
Come on.
The fact that he runs back in is kind of hilarious. I feel like that's not super necessary. Got it!
So, what do you call the over-under on it totally being okay outside versus, like, nothing outside?
Well, if it's nothing outside, then...
It's just kind of a bummer.
It's kind of a bummer. I guess there's some pretty interesting implications if it's good outside. And, like... Like, I think it's probably safe to say it's not like civilization is back to normal. But... Is the air breathable?
I mean, without proper medical attention, which he clearly does not have the ability to do, he's going to die soon anyway.
Not necessarily. I would say it's probably likely.
Like, his arm is definitely messed up.
Yeah, his arm's super messed up and is at a super high risk for an infection. But that's not necessarily that means he's going to die.
Or does it, yeah, open and then, like, fade to white as he opens the door? That would bug me if it does that. Does the, like, Truman Show move?
It probably would. Well, I mean, the Truman Show...
It's good in the Truman Show,
but
move of the, like, open the door as it goes light.
I mean, if he gets upstairs and he says, good morning, good afternoon, and good night, or whatever it is, good evening. Oh, creepy. Creepy barks.
Yeah.
Just go!
I mean, how messed up this guy is...
Oh, yeah.
...starts to sort of make sense when you think about it in terms of that he's been alone with his mom, who is clearly also kind of messed up.
Oh, she's super messed up.
For the last 20 years, and before that, in this place where most people hated him.
Come on!
I mean, what's interesting is that didn't he have like 26 years worth of food?
Yeah.
For just himself? So I guess, yeah, but that's 20 years. Yeah. I don't know. I guess there's some math that can be done there, but.
I mean, there was a 50 something? Imaginary people grabbing my leg. Why did they hate him? Because, I guess they didn't hate him.
I don't think anybody hated him,
Well, except for, I mean, the people who were in charge thought he was just a huge pain in the ass.
Yeah, he's just a little kid.
So, and he was using resources without contributing anything for at least the first, 10 years or so.
Yeah.
When clearly resources were at an all-time premium.
Or he's gonna die before we reach the top, but it pans out to show a non-messed up outside. Yeah. I'm still on the side of it was never messed to begin with.
And it was just misinformation coming down?
Misinformation, or... Who knows? No, I'm good. I'm okay to get out.
Everything I did for you.
You can't leave me, John. Stay with me.
Why would you...
You promised.
This is what you would want.
Everything
mom.
I did for you.
and I've taken the squirrel supplies off.
And spit it out.
14 months. After that's finished.
Margaret,
where's the Lindane report?
That top left. You and Evelyn had it from Mrs. Harrison.
Jesus.
How long before it's safe to go back up?
20 or 30 years.
So she did the math.
So she did the math and realized that if she killed everybody, they could survive for 20 or 30 years?
I guess.
Actually, even longer. Like, they could have been down there for 40 years.
Mom?
Whew. Lord Xerox says, meep meep.
Thanks, Lord Xerox. 5 months, appreciate it.
I mean, this is interesting, right? It's that there's all this tension and stuff, when actually most of it is flashback, right?
Yeah.
Nothing that scary has actually happened to him. I mean, he broke his arm, but that was just because he fucked up.
He's also completely alone right now, which is kind of fucked up. This is when you're realizing that your mom is kind of a bitch and that you're going to leave. Oh!
Oh.
Oh! Love it! I love it! Yes! We get the choice!
Save. Can we save Scum this choice?
Can you? I'm out.
I mean...
No, you cannot. There's no saving.
It's definitely die or maybe die is the option.
So, okay. We got some time.
Are we going to straw poll this?
No, we're not going to straw poll this. I'm going to give my... I'm going to say what I'm going to do, and then you can say what you would do. Because the second I'm given those options, I know what I'm going to do. I don't have to think about it here. 100% I'm hitting leave if this is entirely up to me. Hmm. There is no way in hell, if I was playing this game at home by myself, I would have hit leave the second it popped up.
Right.
I would have seen stay or leave, and I've been, fuck that, I'm not staying. That's not the kind of end experience I want from this game. I want to see what happens when I hit save, or when I hit stay. But as the person who's played through this game, my choice is leave.
Yeah, narratively, maybe stay makes sense, but in the context of the game, there's literally no reason to stay. And well, every reason to leave.
Yeah, the reason that you stay is that you feel like he has not reached a point where he's willing to admit that his mom was kind of a monster. By leaving, you're saying, I understand what happened, you know, I understand what happened now, this is wrong, and I stay, I'm just...
Couldn't it also just be like... It's like, yeah, mom told me not to leave, but this is, you know, extenuating circumstances.
For staying?
For leaving. Yeah.
Well, for leaving, I feel like in my opinion, like, I feel like if I hit that leave button, it's the character realizing that shit was really fucked up back then, and my mom made a mistake, and I want to get the fuck out of here.
But it's like, but the problem is, it's like, stay is die.
Stay is absolutely die.
But it's like, it's not like he has a choice of either leaving to an uncertain future or staying to continuous life the way it was.
Well, yes, yeah, right.
Because it's leave to an uncertain future or stay to a certain death.
Well, it's stay to an almost immediate death.
Yeah.
We know that he will die within a week if he stays. That's because we saw that chart.
Yeah.
And we know that the rad level downstairs is... beyond fixable. We can't fix it. So, if we stay, we die. And that's the other reason why I want to say leave, is because I don't think that this character deserves to die.
Hmm. I guess the question is, like, is if he, like, goes out into the real world, goes into the world, and people are there, can he, you know, he can't really tell them what happened.
No. Well, he can't tell them what happened, but he can easily tell them, you know, he could tell them what happened. He could be honest and tell them, or he could lie. But regardless, if we leave, he has that option.
Yeah.
If we'd stay,
there isn't an option.
Yeah, I think we gotta leave.
Yeah, I'm gonna hit leave. That being said, I'd still really like to see, and I'll probably have to just go on YouTube to see
it. Yeah, maybe we can watch it on YouTube, yeah.
Is because if you stay and see, okay, we're gonna leave. We're gonna see what happens.
Open the door, brick wall.
I mean, this could be the open to white, and that's it. Oh.
Well, there's still grass. Breathe. Good start.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. Okay.
Penderland. Yeah, interesting from a, you know, from the idea of, from like a horror perspective. Everything that was horrifying was actually in his head.
Oh yeah.
Nothing actually bad. I mean,
well, I mean it was
the place was breaking down, but
yeah.
But nothing
Editor Bryn.
But
good
nothing
job, Bryn.
Bad.
Yeah, the world outside is not as important as his choices to leave. But you don't need... The resolution is that he made the choice to leave.
Yeah.
That is the resolution. You don't need more than that.
Like, there isn't, like... I guess it means that there isn't the twist of... Like, we can... Because they didn't show anything, we can assume that what we know of the world... from the game was correct.
Yeah.
That there was a thing, and theoretically enough time has passed that it might be safe outside.
Yeah, exactly. It's not like
it's
you
not
walked
like
outside.
It's not like there was some twist and you walked outside and it was like a park and the kids are playing.
Or it's like, congratulations, you're the winner of Last Man Standing or something stupid like that. Like, now speedrun the game to the other ending. I don't actually think you can really speedrun this that well. We could probably
I mean, there's a few things that you don't have to look at.
I think you can skip a bunch of stuff, but I'm still not gonna, it's still probably like another half an hour to get through it, so.
But you've explained why leave is the only option the character can arrive at after all the
I do agree that him fighting through everything and getting down into the basement and doing the stuff and then leaving makes no narrative, or then staying, makes no narrative sense.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's that you've resigned, I guess, to the fact that, I mean, like, I guess staying means he takes responsibility for what he did, but
right.
I don't think he knew what. I think it's unfair for him to, like, it. Staying is your choice by saying, "I fucked up. I did something wrong. I deserve to die." Because you know you will.
So this idea that he honestly did not realize what had happened to everybody else in the base.
I mean,
until that moment.
Whether or not that's true or not, maybe he's known for a long time and he just didn't want to admit it. And going through all this. All right. So yeah, we're gonna go. We'll get through this and. Watch the stay ending. Phoenix says, here's the stay ending. The stay ending is actually a lot more powerful, I think.
Hmm. Like, I would be... If this was, like, a movie, and he stayed at the
That's
end,
cool.
And he, like, didn't go...
Shot entirely location at a secret...
Oh, neat.
Also, I like how it's the name of it, Secret Nuclear Bunker.
But, like, if this was a movie, and that had all happened, and then he had chosen to stay... I would be very annoyed at that movie.
Yes.
Because it's basically like him deciding to commit suicide at the end.
Yeah, it's him. Yeah. Okay.
So, let's quickly exit the game here, and we'll
go. Nice. The Diet Coke boy says there's, that's the museum bunker near me.
Cool. YouTube. And let's search for the bunker stay ending.
I love that the, all endings. Does it start with the stay or the way to go?
Long live the Queen Elizabeth.
Let's skip. And we can probably skip all this crap.
So that's the leave ending. I love that the previous thing that... Okay, here we go. See more of outside in the stay ending.
You see that it's okay.
I guess, I don't know, does the fact that there are trees around make it okay?
I mean, you see blue sky. The idea is that it would be nuclear winter, right? So this does not look like that.
Yes, that's true.
That's interesting.
It's,
I don't know.
As a side note, I will say the thing about, you know, the gameplay stuff. I was just realizing as we were watching this that just like a view that, like watching a 2-hour YouTube video of this thing.
Yeah.
The experience wouldn't be that much different, I don't think.
Well, yes and no, because you would still be, I mean, you wouldn't be making the choices. So that I could see that being a little frustrating.
Mm.
But so maybe you could actually, maybe it's nuclear.
You could
summer.
Even do it with like YouTube annotations.
Yeah, I mean, it's true. Like it, I think the idea. So I mean, so you guys are saying some interesting things about, I guess, the reality of the fact that Chernobyl has thriving wildlife, but trees and skies, tree and sky means good to enough people that my assumption is that, like, if they wanted to show that it was still shit outside, then they could have done that, right?
I mean,
I
yeah.
feel like...
But I think if they wanted to make it, like, really nice, they would have had, like, people or something. Like, I think they were still being pretty ambiguous about it.
Yeah. Okay.
Like how the desktop is still Gengar's Haunted Mansion.
It sure is. All right. Well, I guess we're done. 2:10.
I guess so. Yeah.
Shorter stream. I mean, I could play Minecraft for.
Is that the first time we've gone through an entire game on New Day?
Yeah, that's the first game we've ever beat on New Day Tuesday. Sweet. I mean, there are games. That's it. Okay. So that's the first game that we've beat that actually was like an actual single player experience. We've obviously played multiplayer games where we've completed games.
Right, but you can't actually like.
But you can't beat it. But yeah, that's the first game we've ever beat, so that's pretty cool. I don't know. I'm curious to know. I'm curious to ask Alex about.
Oh, right, yeah, 18, not New Day.
For what?
This is 18 games and counting, not
New Day. Oh, said New Day. You said New Day. Okay. I just heard 18 days. I think the point of the outside shot is to show there is an outside and the little bunker passes. No one knowing what it is or caring about what happened there beyond the occupant or beyond the occupants. It's an interesting idea. You guys beat RuneScape? Oh yeah, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Go drunk your home. Minecraft, please. I mean, I could, okay, let's go. Let's hop on that server that Alex and I have been playing on.
Yeah, so maybe not actually like playing Minecraft, but can you, yeah, show us what you've been working on.
Sure. You guys can see what I've been working on.
It's called Gengar's Mansion.
I don't know if this, I don't want to
show off the IP just in case. All right. So, this is a Minecraft server that Alex started a week ago.
Fancy sword.
For Talking Simulator, where Cam and him played some Minecraft, and then he's like, oh god, I played Minecraft for 3 hours. Alex showed us yesterday. Oh, okay. Well,
what's the?
You guys can still see some stuff.
What's the map? Is that an actual, a real map?
Yeah, these are real maps.
Do they like change and update?
Yeah. So you can make a giant tile map.
Oh, speaking
and see everything. So it's kind of cool. So I'll just show you the stuff that I've been working on. So over here is going to be the new farms. I started working on that last night.
Everything's covered in torches.
Got to keep it lit. This is what I've spent basically my entire time on. Is this building here?
Very sort of gothic. Oh, hey, this one of these things.
So, I built. This is a storage.
So organized.
Yeah. So the idea is that. First floor of the storage, you come in here, and then you can go upstairs, and then there's a shit ton more storage. And the other idea is this stuff. These are everything that you can smelt in the game. So iron, gold, glass. So sand, you smelt sand, you get glass. Stone, clay bricks, clay blocks, or whatever they're called, hardened clay. This is nether brick, and this is cracked cobble. Or cracked stone bricks. And they're just decorative bricks and stuff like that, right? So the idea...
We should organize the prop room like this.
The idea is...
You need a whole bunch of chests.
You come up here, and you put your iron ore in here. And it automatically goes through the system I've built in behind, smelts, and gets dumped into here.
Oh, what?
there's like
a secret furnace in the back?
Yeah. So if you go around back...
Holy crap. This is very complex.
This is our smelter. This is our smelting setup. So the chest is, you can't see it, but the chest is up in behind this block. There's a hopper here and here that leads into the furnace. And then this chest here leads into the side of the furnace, and that's what feeds it with coal. So there's coal right here now. If I take this coal out and I put it in here, you'll see it starts filtering down, and it's going in here.
Ah.
And then when the completed iron is done, it goes into this hopper, into that hopper, and then gets fed into that chest. And then that's just replicated.
So fancy.
For
so
the first four.
Is there something that
I haven't built? Because this requires a shit ton of iron to make. Because I have to make 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 hoppers, and each hopper requires 5 iron.
Why do you need 2? Is that just to speed it up?
To what?
Like, why is it go? Why are there 2 furnaces and 2?
Because I like symmetry. I could just do it with 1, but this looks prettier for me. Like, I could easily just do 1 chest up here that feeds into this chest that feeds into this, but then I'd have this weird nothing
just,
here.
So it's just because chests are 2 squares wide?
Yeah, it evenly distributes it, so it does make it a little bit faster. So instead of smelting 1, like if I take out that coal and this coal and I put that in here, it actually evenly splits it between the two. So once this all filters out through these, each of these chests or each of these will have 30 coal in them. So it's going to stop at 30.
Is there an automatic way to fill those up with coal?
Not really. I mean, that's the idea with this, is that if theoretically, if this was full of coal, it would last a long time.
Right.
Not to mention that you can make...
That's a 1 square chest right there.
Right here?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is just where I'm storing some extra coal.
But why didn't you use 1 square chest over at the...
Over these?
Yeah.
Well, if you put a chest together, they become 2.
But you could just have used 1, 1, 1, like...
Yes. Well, I'm saying, I could have gone from a double chest...
Oh, I see.
Into a single chest, into a single furnace, but I just like the look of this better.
Fair enough.
It's just creating more work for myself. But that's what I've been working on quite a lot. And then, so the thing that I really need right now, the thing that's a pain in the ass to build is all of these, they're called item frames. So there's these little frames that you can place, and then theoretically you can put like that. So now feathers go in here, right? So people know that this chest has feathers.
Right.
Is the idea. And you can turn them around.
You can like, are those a built-in thing? Is this vanilla you're
buying? This is vanilla, yeah. But the problem is that these each require one piece of leather, and leather only comes from cows, and you can only get cow leather from cows if you kill them. So it's just been a lot of killing cows and then making new cows.
You need to make, clearly you need to make a automatic cow killer.
Yeah, like right now the only way that we're
slaughterhouse,
doing,
I guess.
The only way we're doing cows right now is just, it's just a manual farm over here. It's a chicken. Yep, there's Mikko. Starts at 3 o'clock. So here's our cow farm.
Yeah, it's a pretty good chunk.
It's not bad.
How do cow? How do you get more cows?
Like this. I will show you.
With a mommy cow and a daddy cow.
I don't think I have. No. So let's go down here. Oops. So we need to go down here. This is our tiny little wheat farm. This is why my next project is building a bigger farm, so we can collect more wheat.
There's no reason that this is like in a greenhouse, right? That's just for looks?
That's just for looks. And I'm going to carry that look over here. I'm going to just make one gigantic greenhouse over there is my plan. So we've got some wheat. And let's see if there's any more wheat in here. There is not, I don't think. Nope.
Why is all that stuff in there? What, like, you've got all these other, ooh, this is fancy.
This is just the house that started with. The idea is that we'll move all this, all the product over. I just haven't got, I want all the item frames first.
And that's
before we start moving over. So now you go over here, let yourself in the cow pen, and you'll notice when I go to the straw,
that
attracts cows. If I feed them, they get hearts, and then they breed.
I see.
And if I kill them, they theoretically, and the leather is not a for sure drop. That's the other problem. Oh, I got two pieces there.
If you only have one cow and feed it wheat, does it make another cow?
No, you need two cows.
But no bulls.
No, there's no difference. Yeah, I'm like, here's chickens and here's sheep.
Ooh, blue sheep.
Yeah, there's different colored sheep.
How'd you get a blue sheep?
I don't really know. They spawn like that. And then, yeah, that's what I've been working on, basically.
So if you go, but like, are there some baby cows over there now that you?
Yes, there is. They're just sort of molded into the big cows, sort of clumped together. I guess the other thing that you can see really quickly that I'll show you before we sign off. So the idea with this is there's going to be stairs, like stairs here and then stairs on the next level and then a brick layer that goes all around and then glass all around this. And then up here is going to be our farms. I'm actually a little concerned. I might have to make this farm double high. I'm not sure. And then the idea is to make a sorting facility sort of like this, but for food. Like I'm going to have a separate storage facility, maybe over here, that's just for food and meats and stuff.
You can dye the sheep and then the baby sheep keep the color.
Ah,
I don't think
okay.
That's how genetics works, but okay.
I'm pretty sure that's exactly how genetics works.
I like everybody. I was like, do you need more than one cow? And everyone in the chat is like, that's not how babies work, Paul. And I'm like, well, you need more than cows to make baby cows in the real world, too. So, you know.
Jesus.
Whoa.
It's a big freaking hole.
It's a dangerous hole.
Do I have...
It's like a fallout shelter right there.
I don't. Do I have a shovel? I do.
What? Red, if you have red and blue sheep that... mate, you get a purple sheep?
Yep.
Wow.
There we go. That's a little safer. So if you go this way, because I'm a fan of not... So that's spawn. Like, that's actually, like, server spawn, basically. I'm a fan of not doing my mining by spawn. So there is a mine shaft over there, but it's a fucking mess. And I really don't like messy mines. So I came this way and made my own mine shaft. Which is significantly better laid out. But I'm crazy like that.
I love the idea of like miners, you know, like coming up and they're all covered in coal dust and stuff and being like, we're not going to go back down there. That mine is filthy.
Yeah.
That mine, very poorly laid out.
Down here is my mine. Why? That's bad. This is my garbage. This is where I throw things I don't want. So, the way that this mine shaft works is there's these six branches. And, oh, I need to get more. So, six branches that go, I think, 60 blocks back. And then I dig two down more, and I go 60 more blocks-ish. And I do that over and over and over and over again. So all these are the same. And if I go down there, there's a tunnel that leads straight down like this one. But this one, this tunnel goes all the way around. So if I go down here, the idea being, again, that I will... wherever every two blocks, I'll skip every two blocks and then make another tunnel that goes straight back.
Why skip every two blocks?
Because then you can see. So if I dig here, either side, yeah. Right. If I dig here and here, you can see either sides. So.
So.
So then this goes all the way to here, and then you see you have back down there, and then more mine shafts. I've only done two down here, and then back down to the main thing, and then if I keep going all the way down here.
What do you think it is about Minecraft, or I guess video games like this in particular?
And then there's more mineshafts.
That it's like, and meaning no offense, James, you aren't this organized in your day-to-day life, in your real life. What is it about Minecraft that just either makes it easier?
Well, it is just inherently easier to be this organized in Minecraft, right?
Right. I mean, your day-to-day life obviously has all sorts of complications.
Yeah.
But is it just the ease of doing it?
Yeah, I mean, this is my...
Like, if obviously you're not, you don't mine or whatever, but it's like, if you're... Anyways. If, like, your house in real life or your apartment or whatever could be... this, like, tightly organized, would you want that, or is
no.
it just...
No, it's... I think it's the simplicity of being able to do it in this kind of game. I also, like, I'm a huge fan of symmetry, and that's true in real life. So, and then this is my quick way. So if I go down here... Oops. Let's close that. This takes me to the Nether. This is actually only a one-way Nether... portal, because what happens is this actually drops me into the Nether portal that is back at our base. So this portal here is linked to my mine and our base, because they're not far enough away to create a new portal.
It's actually just a shortcut.
It's just a shortcut from my mine to the base and not the other way around. So now we're back at the base.
Cool.
I've never been up here before.
You're doing it's like the Nightcrawler thing where you teleport through the hell dimension.
Yeah.
Apparently, VR Minecraft is super sweet. What? Why is it on fire?
It's supposed to be. If you light nether brick on fire, it stays on fire forever.
Uh-huh. So this is just like a big tower that it's somebody
like
made?
I think Alex made it sort of like a beacon, like if you get lost... look for the big beacon. I don't think there's any easy way to go down this.
I know one easy way.
Well, I mean an easy way to go down and survive.
Yeah, there should be... Oh, there we go.
Oh, there it is.
Nice. The old one square water chunk.
Yeah.
That's like the high dive onto, like the little cup full of water.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite Minecraft little tricks. Is that it doesn't matter how far you fall, as long as you fall into any part of water. It doesn't even need to be a source block, just water. You will not die. okay. I think that's going to do it, because I have enough time to go quickly grab some food before LurMTG, which is at 3 o'clock today. We changed it in the schedule. We tweeted about it. I apologize if you did not catch that memo. But, yeah. I'm excited. And I think Cam is joining me. I think. I don't actually know. I asked him to. He hasn't responded.
You got the horse back? I thought it was turned into wall meat.
I don't know. It's not my horse. The horse isn't even tied up right now. I thought it had to be. just weird. Oh, it is. It's just not. It's glitched out, I guess. That's weird. All right, guys.
What is it in hours? It is, 32 minutes from now.
Yep. Yeah, we'll be back online in half an hour for Lure MTG. So if that's your jam, stick around, and we'll be back then. And otherwise, thanks for hanging out today on 18 Games. That was fun. We actually beat a game.
Yay.
Get excited. All right, guys.
Those speedrun strats.
Yeah, we sped run it real good. Bye, guys.
Sped run?
Yeah.
Sped ran?
Sped runned?
We sped ran it.
We spun runned it.
All right. See you guys later.
Bye.